This is The Speaking Show. I'm David Newman, and you're tuned in to the number one podcast for speakers, consultants, and experts who want to speak more profitably. My guest today, Doug DeVitri, author of Screen to Screen Selling. But actually, today we're not talking about screen to screen. Today we're talking about voice to voice. Welcome, buddy.
I know we're kind of getting rid of the screens, right?
Screens going away. So talk to me. We got Alexa. We got Google Home. We got these voice. Everyone's listening to us. What's up with this voice stuff? Give us the big picture, then we'll drill into it.
Man, if you remember websites when they first came out, you remember when social media first came out, you remember when mobile apps came out, right? We had to kind of retool ourselves. We had to retool ourselves with a big picture, like why, what's in it for me? And then we had to figure out, well, what is it we're actually trying to do? And then, you know, those of us that made it a priority, we now make it a list, a part of our action items to actually like be there and be there in a way that, you know, supports and resonates with our customers. So the whole voice first movement, and that's what this is called, voice first, is how do you control your devices and how do you get what you want without having to use a computer screen? It's just so fascinating to be kind of at the early stages of what's happening.
So I'm just going to brainstorm a whole bunch of ideas here, and then we'll pick one of these avenues to start with. One thing might be we have a podcast and we want to say, Alexa, play The Speaking Show, for example. We might have little sound bites or tidbits or, you know, Alexa, give me the do it marketing tip of the day. It could be much more sophisticated than that also, but is that what we're talking about, or is there even a bigger game beyond those couple of rudimentary things?
So there's a bigger game, David, and I don't know how high level you want to go, like for as far as my vision for 2020 and then what I'm working on in 2019, but they have Amazon Alexa, and that's kind of the primary platform that I use because it has the highest adoption rate. And they have what's called the Alexa Award, right? And kind of like the award of all awards that they give for the developer who creates the most fascinating experience. And right now, kind of one of the criteria they're using is how long can you have a conversation with one of these chatbots like Alexa, right? And so that the goal was 20 minutes. And if you think about having to have a conversation with a computer for 20 minutes, one that understands you and the one that customizes the conversation, it can get really sophisticated on the back end because you're pulling information that was just talked about in the past to be able to pull in the presence using your insights, very similar to what you do as a coach or as a consultant. So yeah, I mean, you know, we talk about the basics about playing your podcast. You can do that right now. I can go through a whole feature set that would just blow you away in terms of what this little, you know, little device of the size of the hockey puck can do.
Blow us away, dude. I'm ready. I'm listening. What do you got? Let's do it.
So you talked about subscribe to the podcast, right? That's a real simple deal where you plug it in. And before I back up, there's one thing to understand what Alexa can do. And then there's the other side of it that's like, we need to develop for Alexa, right? So I'm going to put we're going to sit in the driver's seat as like how we can program Alexa to create the experience. And when you think of like a mobile app for iPhone or Android, an Alexa skill is the app for the Alexa skill store. So, you know, the Do It podcast or Do It marketing show, your brand would have an Alexa skill. And then all the features very similar to your website would be kind of a part of that. And those features are called intents, right? Like, what do you want Alexa to do? Okay. So we have to figure out, we have to make a list, and then we have to prioritize this list as far as when we go to development, what are these things we're going to actually want Alexa to do? There's the next thing is like, what do we say to Alexa to where we get what we want? And those are called utterances. And you could ask, there'd be, let's say, three different utterances for the same intent. So in other words, if I want to figure out where you work, I'd say, you know, where are you employed? Who writes your paycheck? You know, where do you work? Those would be three different ways of getting the same thing, the intent, where you work. So then I can respond, you know, accordingly. So, you know, we kind of have to map these things out. And there's a couple of different ways of doing that using a Trello board is one that I use. I also use a mind map for the conversation guide. But really, when all these things we can't do, I'll kind of like go through one by one for you. So, you know, you had mentioned play podcast, right? So I could say, Alexa, open Doug DaVitri skill, and then it would play the podcast. It played the most recent episode, and that's all done automatically, right? It just kind of like happens. Now, you might be wondering, well, what if I wanted someone to subscribe to my podcast? How does that happen? Well, here's the problem that you'll run into as you start to develop for Amazon Alexa, or at least now, because, you know, we need to change. It changes all the time. If somebody wants to subscribe to a podcast for Amazon Alexa, what has to happen is you have to ask Alexa to subscribe to the podcast. Alexa will then say back, would you like me to send you a text message? So instead of like just voice, they send you a text message to your mobile app, and then you click on the podcast to subscribe using your favorite player. Now, two things under that situation. Number one, whenever you say something to Alexa and Alexa sends it back, it's called a card response. And you actually see that in your Alexa app when you visit it, your activities as far as what you've just said to Alexa. But really, like, you can't put an active link to click on it inside your Alexa app. Like, Amazon Alexa will not allow external links. So the way around that is by setting up a text message integration that sends a link to the podcast, or very similar to send a link to an opt-in to your email list, or very similar to send a link to buy your book or whatever it might be. So sending subscribe to podcasts is actually through sending a text message. No, should I go on? This is just so exciting.
Well, yes, but let's also maybe take just a quick step back, because I'm thinking about the very early days of iPhone apps. You might remember this. There are some iPhone app makers, right? Like, and what they did, it was super simple. It was like an RSS feed, and then you'd create this little app, and basically you could see your blog on your iPhone. And people are like, oh my God, I have my own iPhone app. It's like, dude, it's a simple RSS little app that someone kind of baked and put your logo on it, and then put your little, you know, 150 by 150 pixel icon art on it. And then it's in the app store, and then woohoo. I mean, super simple. Are there super simple things that we can do right now just to dip our toe in? Like those early primitive iPhone apps.
Totally. And the difference with Alexa, some of those options are free. So if you just Google Amazon Alexa blueprints, you know, when you think of a Microsoft PowerPoint template or you think of a Microsoft Word template, they're kind of schematics, right, for the design for the program. So very similar to that one, Amazon Alexa, you have what we have called blueprints. You don't need to know a line of code. The only thing you have to know is what the user would say to Alexa to get Alexa to respond. And then you would type in the script for what Alexa says.
Let's say we make one of those.
Yeah.
And I've played with that. And it's like, it's fun. But that only exists on my Alexa device and on my phone. It's not published out into the universe. So how do we go from that kind of dialogue that we pre-script in the blueprint to publish that out so you can have it and every listener to this podcast can have it and my dog can have it and we can all have it?
It's such a great question. This changes all the time. So a couple of weeks ago, they just allowed Alexa skill blueprints that you can publish them to the store. So this means you don't have to have an Amazon developer account. You don't have to set up Amazon Web Services on the background and understand Lambda functions, Node.js, and the programming language that's like on the back end. Now, I'll tell you why you want to make the transition from a blueprint to a custom skill, if you want to know that. This is where, like, for authors, for professional speakers, for thought leaders, for podcasters, right? You want to ask yourself, well, how do you monetize this thing? And so this is where you would get into developing a custom skill. This is where you would hire somebody who specializes in this. And this is so funny. You know, we were both at the National Speaker Association Winter Conference, right?
Yeah.
And, you know, I did my session earlier on voice, and then, you know, Randy Gage gets up to the stage, and we all know Randy. And Randy, someone from the crowd asks him, you know, in 2019, what's the one thing you want to do, you know, as far as your plan? And he says, you know, I'm going all in on voice. And it's funny because everyone kind of looked back at me and said, you know, like, like, is this real? Is this happening? And my phone started blowing up. So I talked to Randy, and Randy's like, Randy and I are doing this together. And the difference between what we're doing together on this is we're monetizing the skill using Amazon Pay and Alexa. So there's a whole e-commerce engine on the back end that sells physical products, sells services, sells tickets to events, think of Amazon Alexa as a learning management system that when you talked about giving free tips, after a certain amount of tips, then there can trigger an upsell to say, hey, buy the in-app, or in this case, in-skill purchase to access more tips. So there's all these different ways we can monetize Alexa through the integration of Amazon Pay, which is on the e-commerce side of things, so that any one of your customers can buy what you have to sell.
Hey, this interview is a real moneymaker. If you're serious about ramping up your reach and revenue as a speaker, trainer, or expert, book a confidential speaker strategy call with our team. The link is doitmarketing.com/call. It will be the most valuable 45 minutes you invest in your speaking-driven business. Speaking of value, let's get back to the show. So you could build, and maybe you're doing this, right? You could build a Doug's Real Estate Marketing Tip of the Day. And 27 of those are free. And on day 28, it's like, hey, if you want to unlock the other 90 tips, it'll be $1.99 or something like that, correct?
Yeah, you bet. And you think about the tips are, you be type out what Amazon Alexa says, or the tips could be access to highly specialized audio, like a secure MP3 you would put behind a paywall, or it could be access to videos. You know, the other day, my son, he just turned 4. He says, Alexa, play Paw Patrol on Amazon Prime for kids. And I'm thinking, oh no, I better lock down my paywall or my voice purchasing, because you never know where this thing is going to go. So look, you know, any marketer out there that who has great content is looking to be on a new channel and really differentiate themselves. I mean, I didn't even talk about what you can do with Alexa on stage, you know, for speaking. I mean,
yeah, well, let's talk about that in a minute.
Yeah.
I want to also go back to the early days of the iPhone app, the early days of CD-ROMs. We used to have, back in the day, and you remember this, we used to have what we call shovelware, where we just take a whole bunch of crap that already exists, whole bunch of PDFs, whole bunch of Word docs, whole bunch of videos, whole bunch of audios, and we threw it on a CD-ROM. And now we said, hey, I've got a CD learning program. And it was this random bunch of crazy unconnected stuff. And that obviously got more sophisticated. Yeah. Same thing with like membership websites. Yeah. When membership websites were new, that was a victim of shovelware. Oh, here's a bunch of random unconnected videos. Here's some downloads. Here's some worksheets. Good luck. We're going to unlock the portal and charge you $9.99 a month. Is there a risk when we're looking at this without a game plan that Alexa becomes like a dumping ground for old, outdated content, and it's going to be a whole bunch of crap out there that people are not going to want to listen to or engage with?
It's more complicated than what we have for typical websites, right? Look, anybody who's going into this right now is looking at this a couple of different angles. Like you just said, how do we take our existing content and just put it in here and monetize it? And we structure it in a way that our website, look, that's not going to work. And you're going to go through the growing pains initially when you first start out, and your development costs are going to be up higher in the end because you're having to go back and change and iterate on the conversational guide and iterate on the back end code to be able to support this. So like, if you really want to do this right, you have to start out with a conversational guide that, you know, you give some free tips in the beginning, and you use Alexa to develop rapport with your customer in a way that builds trust to then sell the next thing that's absolutely related to that existing conversation. Not do like, you know, you're talking about, you know, prosperity here, and then you're selling math. like that, just like the two have to be connected. And so it's extremely important early on inside of that conversation guide that you're mindful of that, and you don't just like, you know, end up with a developer bill, you know, 6 months later and say, oh my gosh, nobody's using my stuff.
Right, right. So let's now switch to what you were mentioning a moment ago, which is we're on stage, we plug in our friendly hockey puck companion, and we're giving a presentation to a group or a training session. What are some cool ways that we can use Alexa or voice technology on stage as part of our program?
So this is so great. We'll refer to what we can do on the Amazon Alexa blueprints, because that way, like, you don't walk out of this and say, oh my gosh, I got to spend a bunch of money on stuff. Like, you can get started today with the Alexa blueprints and then use this on stage, right?
Right.
So, you know, and the other day at the NSA Winter Conference, you know, Frances Rios was the organizer, and then she knew she was going to be in my session. So I said, Alexa, who's the best professional speaker, right? You know, we always want to lift our clients up, right? We always want to lift the people around us to support us. So, and Frances will be in the room. So I said that, you know, Alexa says, Frances is the number one keynote speaker, and that you need to grow, you know, if you would be a fool not to hire her, boom, shakalaka, boom. Right? And here's the thing, is if Alexa says it, it must be true, right? Just like the internet.
For sure. Absolutely.
So when you think about what we can call out, and like, you know, like you've got callbacks, or you have like your save lines that you pull up, you want to insert into the program somehow, you know, Amazon Alexa as your sidekick will always be there for you, just like a flip chart would be, just like a PowerPoint presentation would be, or some sort of prop that you use. So if we get in the mindset that we can use Alexa to engage with our audience and not just share information, it'll really hit home. There's another way where you can use a quiz game, where you can actually quiz the audience on their knowledge. You know, so if Alexa says, you know, what's the tallest mountain in the world? Is it number one? Is it number two? Is it number three? Is it number four? You can see everybody's heads, like, or their eyes, you know, go to the back of their head. They're thinking like, oh my gosh, what's the tallest mountain in the world? And you have them totally engaged. And here's the thing, Alexa's so fast, right? Like, you better know your stuff. So there's a sense of urgency in the learning that keeps you sharp, right? And I think as more people do this, the more they start to see that, like, I don't know if there's any like scientific research on this yet, but just from doing this over and over again, you can see that it really connects with folks.
So Alexa is really, that's the game right now. As you and I are recording this, it's not going to be Google. It's not going to be Microsoft. We should really focus on the 800-pound gorilla, which is in this case, Amazon and the Alexa ecosystem.
Yeah, you know, that's no different if you look at your website and you're going to, you know, let's say you have 10 pages on there, you're not going to spend time on the one page that doesn't get any traffic. You know, you're going to really like spend time on the pages that get the most amount of traffic. So, you know, people go to Google to search, they go to Amazon to buy traditionally, right? And that's the reason why Amazon has such a high adoption rate, because they were able to see their devices so quickly across, I mean, gosh, 50 million households have one of these now. It's insane.
Yeah.
So like, why wouldn't you, especially when you look at it in the same way you would a website? It's like a 24/7 you, just in a different type of format.
Now, I know that you talk to a lot of industries, but you have sort of a specialization in real estate and maybe a couple other niches. Are there certain industries that should really be getting on top of this sooner than the others? Yeah. Are there some patterns that you're seeing just as you go around the country speaking and training that you're like, wow, this is going to be hot in these two industries or these three industries? What do you think?
So, you know, I grew up in the real estate world, so I can speak the real estate language really easily. And that's going to, it's going to have a profound impact on that market. But I'd say probably the one that people aren't thinking about is healthcare. Healthcare. You think of how many folks can't use a screen, or they can't type, or, you know, they're kind of secluded, or they're in a bed and they can't like move around. They can easily turn over to Alexa to ask them something, especially somebody with dementia. Now, I don't know anybody personally does, but I know other people who, you know, if the family members have dementia. What they're telling me is when they're using it with Alexa, people with dementia, they forget things, right?
For sure.
So if you just keep on asking Alexa, you have somebody there who always is going to have an answer for you, and not like, you know, sometimes someone with dementia, you know, you might get upset with them. Like, there's no emotion with Alexa, right? Okay. She'll keep answering it, and you know, she's your friend. So healthcare is going to be probably one of the top ones that I see Alexa benefiting the most.
Now, let's do a little inside baseball, because in addition to sharing expertise, you know, part of the speaking show is kind of how are you pivoting your business based on the marketplace, based on what your clients and audiences want. So for years and years, you were sort of like the social media technology guy, you know, technology and sales, technology and kind of future trends a little bit. Screen to Screen Selling was the last book. How did this come to you that, you know what, I got to jump ahead of this voice thing. This voice thing is going to be the next giant wave. And tell us about how you pivoted some of your speaking and some of your attention and some of your research into this area, and when you knew that it was smart to do so and safe to do so.
You know, David, that's a really good question and some keen observations there too. When I got into screen-to-screen selling, this is back in like 2014 when I knew that was a direction for me and I was going to write my first commercial published book with that, like people were using the stuff, but they didn't know how to use it really well, right? Like nobody had heard of Zoom back then. People were still talking about Google Hangouts and GoToWebinar, stuff like that. And you know, what are we using today, right? Like everyone's on the platform. So I don't know. There's this thing where people have like an adoption and then there seems to be like a lull. And I think for anybody, right? It doesn't even have to be technology specific. At least in my opinion, I always have to keep like challenging myself. Right? I have to keep reaching at least a couple years out on the trend line and then stay ahead of that trend line. So when the trend becomes, should I say, popular, that like I'm already positioned well as an expert far ahead than anybody would take the time to even like think of going down that road, right? Like I don't think there's not going to be many people that go down the Alexa path because it's deep. Like it is a very like, I'm in 2 years of like, under the hood of this type of platform and people are just finally unpacking their Echo Dots, right? Like they got it for Christmas. And you can see it in the contact. This is so fascinating. You can see it on the contacts list that's tied with the next Alexa, how many people actually have it. So, you know, with this type of model, it continues to challenge me on different skill sets that I never had before. So then I become much more valuable to one of my clients. So I can go like, I mean, last week I was doing HR work, organization work. Like you would never, nobody ever would think of that I do that. Somebody said I should probably talk about that more, but like I'm continuously improving my skill sets to make myself more valuable for my clients, and Alexa just happens to be one of them.
Super quick commercial break. Isn't this interview amazing? If you'd like to get more ideas on how to start or grow your speaking business fast, pop over to our free training at doitmarketing.com/webinar. So the screen-to-screen selling book was McGraw-Hill, correct?
Yeah.
And is there going to be a voice-to-voice selling or a voice-to-voice book? Is that the sequel coming up?
You know, I did write the outline for that. I think it's definitely doable, and now might be the time to move that forward. Look, I'm all in on this platform. I'm hosting a skill-building summit, which is a full-day program on how people can kind of do this for themselves. You know, this is in Washington, D.C. in May. Like, I've got back-end resources that are highly customized and templates people to fill out so they don't have to, like, spend time doing it. I tell you, like, you know, the value that we bring to folks is, like, doing a lot of the legwork ahead of time so they don't have to spend so much time in the weeds figuring this out. So a lot of the attention, like smart home guides, get started quick guides, and then like specialized reports. And that way, no matter who you are, where you are, kind of in the process, that you can kind of latch on and start to join on this journey.
Who do you think, as far as your speaking audiences, consulting and training audiences, is this more of an entrepreneurial thing where people who are agile and can move fast and can, you know, put these things together quickly without a lot of paperwork and bureaucracy, is that where it's going? Or is it more like with the web and with podcasts and with everything, like the big giant Fortune 500 corporations, just because of sheer resources, they're going to be the first ones to the finish line? What do you think about that?
No, that's a great conversation, David. And so I want you to think about, like, when you get into the enterprise level Amazon Alexa skill, I mean, we're talking where everything's done right to a T, and there's lots of checks and balances for quality assurance. Right? Yeah. And so I put this together. There's 12 different roles, specialized roles needed to support an enterprise level Amazon Alexa skill. 12. Okay. Now, if you have corporate, who's a part of this, you have 12 different roles. That means 12 different opinions go into the project, which then it's just like, which way are we going? It ends up being like something that is completely different from what the customer experiences would be. Now, if you're an entrepreneur and you have a lot of these, if you develop some of these skills or you know how to delegate some of these skills inside of a defined process, you're going to be able to beat the big brands. Like, there's no doubt about it. So there's like pros and cons to it, but just understand for the entrepreneur at play, you know, if you understand project management and you have a lot of the folks already like connected, like a video editor, an audio editor, a graphic design, somebody who can do to send traffic, because you know, you create this great skill and nobody uses it. it's a big failure. So we got to get people to use it by sending them traffic and you know, building a funnel. It's another skill set. So there's all these different like parts to this puzzle. It's not just, you know, what can I say to Alexa for her to respond?
But so it sounds like the baby step is get conversant with the Amazon blueprints, start building a couple of little fun things that you can use yourself, both at home and on stage, and then see where that goes. And then if you want to get into the more robust kind of professional version, then you're going to do a custom skill, which is going beyond the kind of do-it-yourself blueprints.
I mean, look, for the Randy Gage skill, right? I mean, you can buy his book, you can get leads from it, you can order products. Like if you were to say, listen to Randy speak, it'll play Randy's video on the Echo show, and then it'll play the audio, the MP3 on one of the Echo Dot devices. Like, right. So it actually knows which device that it's there. And so like, that's where it gets like a little bit more complicated. But I mean, what a cool like little feature set that you can just plug right in. So that people like know, you know, who you are and what you do.
Right. Absolutely. And so this is like, imagine if we had gotten in on the very early days of the web, or the very early days of anything, the very early days of podcasting, the very, like when there was maybe just a few thousand or a few tens of thousands, right? Now there's like billions of websites. There's 500,000 podcasts. Podcasts, by the way, still total blue ocean, because do you want to be one of 500,000 podcasts, or do you want to be one of many, many billion websites and blogs and web pages? So this is, I think, is the cleanest, clearest blue ocean where you can own your domain, you can own your content subject matter in the Alexa world, and people shouldn't miss out on this, correct?
Yeah, there's, I can't remember exactly like the number of changes. Last time I checked, there were 70,000 Amazon Alexa skills. I don't know how many podcasts and how many websites, like hundreds of thousands and millions, but there's only 70,000. And even like inside of your niche, 5, maybe 10.
Yeah.
People who are doing it well, really, really well, maybe one, probably nobody. You know, you can tell on the reviews, right?
Yeah. There you go. Wow.
That's a whole other strategy right there. Like, you know, you launch a skill, we got to get the reviews up. So lots of detail.
Which brings me to, how do people get connected and stay connected to you, the voice first guy? Website, resources, links, what can we connect up in the show notes that people will want to get a hold of?
Yeah, cool. So probably the easiest website is alexa.dougdevitry.com.
That's your Alexa resource page.
Yeah, that's my Alexa. And that's one of them, right? And I think when you go through that, you'll see that there's a lot more resources. There's a Facebook group. We've got a podcast going right now. Like, we're really going heavy to really like explore, just like we are right now, but really getting the details so people can actually like do this for themselves.
Love it. Well, we're going to have you back, because like you said a few minutes ago, this changes daily, and it's a very fast-moving, very exciting area. And so let's see where this is in 3 or 4 months, and then we'll have to have you back on another episode.
Cool, David. Well, I always appreciate it. You're always ahead of the trend, so I'm glad to stay connected. Thanks.
I'm only ahead of the trend because I got great guests like you, dude. That's my only claim to being ahead of any trend. Trust me. All right. Thank you, Doug.
Thanks, David.
Well, that wraps up another episode of The Speaking Show. Hey, tell you what, if you like us, rate us and review us on iTunes. Subscribe. Tell a friend. Go grab the notes and downloads and extras at thespeakingshow.com. See you next time.